Hi students, how are you? This is ASB, your chemistry lecturer. In previous class onwards, we started objective problems in solutions topic. Now also we continue the same topic. After finishing this exercise, then we have to start which questions they already asked in previous JE and NEET exams will continue. Is it clear? Now carefully follow these questions and you have to try to solve these questions. Okay, now already the soft copy with in your group already available. Is it clear? Now already in previous session 12 problems completed. Now 13th problem onwards we have to start. Come to here in 13th problem, how to see, read the first problem. For a solution containing non-volatile solute, the relative lowering of vapor pressure is 0.2 if the solution contain 5 moles in all. Which of the following is true? Means all together, now how many moles of solute plus solvent is there? 5 moles. All moles means sum of solute plus solvent is equal to 5 moles. Here you see, sir, this is colligative based problem. Which colligative property means relative lowering of vapor pressure. According to relative lowering of vapor pressure, P10 minus P1 by P10 is equal to X2, where X2 is nothing but number of moles of solute by number of moles of solute plus solvent, N2 plus N1. Here already they given N1 plus N2 is equal to 5. X2, here you see, sir, here relative lowering of vapor pressure, that is one more value, relative lowering of vapor pressure, P10 minus P1 by P10 is equal to the given more relative lowering of vapor pressure, given value is 0.2. This is equal to what, sir? Mole fraction of solute. Therefore, here N2 by N1 plus N2 is equal to 0.2. Already N1 plus N2 value available. N2 by 5 is equal to 0.2. N2 is equal to 0.2 into 5, that is equal to 1 mole. Here N2 1 mole means all moles are 5. Therefore, N1 is equal to 5 minus 1, 4 moles. This is the data. Carefully see, according to relative lowering of vapor pressure, 0.2 they given, from total number of moles 5 they given. Based on that, here mole fraction of, according to Raoult's law, relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to mole fraction of the solute. Okay, mole fraction of solute value 0.2. Here more relative lowering of vapor pressure 0.2, that is equal to mole fraction of solute. Mole fraction of solute means N2 by N1 plus N2. Here N1 plus N2 5. From that I calculated number of moles of N2. Therefore N2 is equal to 1 mole, then N1 is equal to 4 mole. Come to the given statements. First one, here you see, sir, which of the following are true they are asking. You have to check. Mole fraction of solute in the solution is 0.2, correct only. Reason, mole fraction of solute is equal to relative lowering of vapor pressure. Now come to here, number of moles of solute in the solution is 0.2, wrong statement. Reason, number of moles of solute present in the solution 1 mole. Okay, so second statement is wrong. Next, third one, number of moles of solvent in the solution is 4. Number of moles of solvent already we got here, 4 moles. For that, no problem. Next, mole fraction of solvent is 0.2. Wrong, sir. But here, mole fraction of solvent, if you want, means mole fraction of solute 0.2, mole fraction of solvent here, that is X1, mean what, how to get here 1 minus x2 that equal to 1 minus 0.2 that equal to 0.8. Is it clear? So fourth option wrong. Here which are the correct options? First one, mole fraction of solute in the solution 0.2. Okay, correct. Next one, third option, number of moles of solvent in the solution 4. In these given statements, here first and third statements are correct. First and third correct means if we are getting here option C. We'll come to the next problem. Check, sir. A complex containing K plus ion, platinum 4 plus ion, Cl minus ion is 100% ionized, giving I equal to 3. Thus complex is, carefully see, sir. Here one more point given. In that here I is equal to 3 given. I means want of factor 3. Number of 40, these all are electrolytes. Here electrolytes case I value how to calculate? Number of particles after dissociating by number of particles before dissociating. So before dissociating one particle, after dissociating how many getting? That is only become I value. Come to here, this is K. If we dissociated, what we are getting, sir? 2K plus PT Cl 4 minus 2. In this complex, total 2 plus 1 ion, 3 we are getting. Here I is equal to 3 by, these are final number of particles. Before dissociating how many particles? Only 1. So here I value is 3. Okay. But one more litigation they given here. Platinum oxidation state plus 4 should be present. If we calculate oxidation state of here platinum, here each chlorine is, carefully see, PT Cl4 minus 2, PT we want to calculate, plus 4 into each chlorine minus 1 equal to minus 2. Therefore PT minus 4 take into that side, plus 4 minus 2 become plus 2. So here according to platinum, in this complex platinum exhibit plus 2, but according to the problem platinum exhibit plus 4 oxidation state. So this is wrong option. Now come to the here, total how many ion? Here also total 3 ion we are getting. Now you have to see, write down what are we are getting. 2K plus PT Cl6 minus 2, total 2 plus 1, 3 ion, I is equal to 3 by 1, 3 only. Here ionized, complete ionized means here want of factor 3. Can you check the oxidation state of this one to calculate this one? Here is this platinum Cl6 minus 2. Platinum 6 into minus 1 is equal to minus 2. If it's minus 1 into 6, minus 6 if you go that side, plus 6, plus 6 minus 2, plus 4. Is it clean? So here plus 4, actually I3 means both complex we are getting, A option, B option will come. But platinum 4 litigation is there. In first complex platinum exhibit plus 2, in second complex platinum exhibit plus 4 oxidation state. Based on given data, correct option is B. In this problem, if pKa is equal to negative log of Ka, that equal to 4, means power of Ka value they given, okay, K and Ka is equal to C alpha square, sir, you remember, it is Ka, you remember, C alpha square, it is not A, C alpha square, okay. Then want of factor for weak monobasic acid, want of factor for weak monobasic acid they are asking. Carefully see, here C means concentration, alpha means degree of dissociation, Ka equilibrium constant of acid. So from this alpha square is equal to Ka by C. Here alpha is equal to square root of Ka by C. Alpha square is equal to Ka by C. Alpha is equal to square root of Ka by C. Here Ka value they given already, Ka not given, sir. Pka given. Pka is equal to 4. Then Ka is equal to 10 to the power minus pka. First year equilibrium equilibrium chapter you learn this formula. Here what pka given? 4, sir. Pka for formula what, sir? Ka is equal to 10 to the power of minus pka. From that here ka is equal to 10 to the power minus pka value available 4. 10 power minus pka means 10 power minus 4. Already see the given concentration 0.01, they become 10 to the power minus 2. From this you have to write what, sir? Alpha is equal to square root of Ka 10 to the power minus 4 by 10 to the power minus 2. Here it become 10 to the power minus 2 by 10 to the power minus 1, that equal to 10 power minus 1. It means 0.1 alpha value we are getting. From this, weak monobasic acid HA dissociate into H plus A minus. How many ions we are getting here? 2 ion after dissociation. So I value how much here? N value 1 plus 1, 2. This is the N value. N is nothing but number of particle after dissociating. Carefully see. Here I is equal to formula. One top factor for dissociation. I equal to 1 plus N minus 1 alpha. 1 plus your N value 2 minus 1. Alpha value how much, sir? Already we calculated 0.1. 2 minus 1, 1. 1 into 0.1, 0.1. Therefore, answer 1.1. This is the Wanta factor. I value here you see. I how much we are getting? 1.1. In given option, which is correct option, sir? C option is correct. Come to this problem. pH and Wanta factor relation, sir. pH of 1 molar HA means weak monobasic acid, this also. pH of 1 molar weak acid is 2. Hence Wanta factor is pH value they given. From this, how to calculate Wanta factor? We have to see. Here weak monobasic acid, this concept also useful to calculate this one. Carefully see. Here pH value 2 and H plus ion concentration is equal to 10 power minus pH. Therefore, H plus ion concentration is equal to 10 to the power minus 2. Now come to the acid. HA acid they given. Weak acid, it dissociate into H plus and A minus. Sir, initially this concentration 100. After some time, out of this one, alpha dissociated. Here alpha dissociate means here how much produce? Alpha. Here also how much producer? Alpha. Is it clean? Now our out of, generally we are taken C. If C concentration 0 will take. Out of C, C alpha dissociated. Here means how much produce? 1:1:1. C alpha. If C take common, what we are getting? 1 minus alpha. Sir, here C value they given for us 1. Therefore, what we are getting, sir? Here 1 minus 1 alpha, 1 alpha. In the place of C, just I wrote 1. So from this, H plus ion concentration is equal to 1 alpha. Here alpha value already available. H plus ion concentration already available. That is what, sir? 10 to the power minus 2. From this, alpha equal to by 1, here alpha equal to 10 power minus 2 by 1, therefore here alpha value 10 power minus 2. Alpha we are getting, degree of dissociation we are getting, from this we have to calculate, from alpha we have to calculate want of factor. For dissociation case, I is equal to 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha, 1 plus, here how many particles obtained here, 2, means n value 2 minus 1 into 0.01, 0.10 to the power of minus 2 means 0.01. Here 2 minus 1, it become 1, 1 into 0.01, it become 0.01, plus 1, it become 1.01. This is the want of factor in given problem. So simple, what's are here, from pH, H plus ion we are getting, from this H plus ion concentration is equal to C alpha, actually C value they given 1, so 1 alpha is equal to 10 power minus 2, alpha equal to 10 power minus 2, alpha value substituting in want of factor in dissociation case, finally I value we got, how much sir, 1.01 in this given option C. Which of the following, or in which case want of factor is maximum? Highest want of factor where it is exhibited, that is we have to check in given options, all options we have to check sir. If which of the following are in which like that questions, all options we have to carefully check in these type of questions sir. Here 50% ionized, 40% ionized, 30% ionized, 20 means this is what sir, alpha percentage. From this alpha how to get, how to see here, alpha is equal to alpha percent by 100, therefore here what sir, 50 by 100, it equal to 0.5. in the same way here alpha 40 by 100, 0.4, here alpha 30 by 100, 0.3, here 0.2, alpha values they given like that. Now we have to calculate first option here, KCl dissociate into K plus plus Cl minus, where I is equal to, here how many particles obtained after dissociation, 2 particle, means n is equal to 2 sir. Now 1 plus formula n minus 1 alpha, based on this formula 1 plus 2 minus 1 alpha value 0.5, therefore here 2 into 2 minus 1, 1, 1, 1 into 0.5, 0.5, it become 1 plus 0.5, 1.5. Option B, here how many particles are obtained here, K2SO4, means it gives 2 potassium ions, 1 sulfate ion, means 2 plus 1, 3, I value 3, so here, N value 3 sir, I is equal to 1 plus n value 3 minus 1, alpha value how much sir, 0.4, here 2 into 3 minus 1, 0.2, 2 into 0.4, 2 into 0.4, 0.8 plus 1, this is 1.8, C, here FeCl3, 1 iron, 3 chlorine, total n value 4, carefully see, 1 plus 4 minus 1 into 0.3. Here you see 4 minus 1, 3. 3 into 0.3, 0.9. 0.9 plus 1, 1.9. Next, fourth option D, I is equal, before going to here, SN, 1 plus 4 chlorines, total 5 sir. Now come to here, 1 plus n value 5 minus 1, alpha how much sir, 0.2 into 0.2, 4 in 5 minus 1, 4 into 0.2, 0.8 plus 1, total 1.8. In these four options, highest I value we are getting third. So FeCl3, 30% ionized. What will happen, sir? More want off factor as compared to A, B and C options. 30% we can't see. How many particle after dissociation? That value also important to find out the want off factor. Come to the next problem. 18 grams of glucose is present in 1000 grams of aqueous solution of glucose, it's said to be. What we call, they're asking, sir, here this is molality relation. Molal, they mention molality is equal to mass of solute by molar mass of solute into 1000 by mass of solvent in grams. Carefully see, here mass of solute 18 grams they given, glucose molar mass 180 grams into 1000 by solution mass 1000 grams they given, in that 18 grams glucose is there. So solvent mass means solution mass minus solute means 1000 minus 18, it gives 982. You write here 982. Sir, you see, if you can 0 cancel 18 100 by 982, we are getting 0.101. small m means molality. So based on this nearer option, 0.1 molal is fourth option is correct. In this problem, you see, molecular weight of NaCl determined by studying freezing point depression of is 0.5%. Aqueous solution is 30. The apparent degree of dissociation of NaCl is, sir, here abnormal molecular mass they given, that is 30. From this, they are asking degree of dissociation. Sir, abnormal molecular mass given, normal molecular mass of NaCl we know. Based on that, I is equal to normal molar mass by abnormal molar mass. Here I is equal to, what's the normal molar mass of glucose? 58.5 by 30, it is equal to 1.95 we are getting. So this is abnormal molar mass by abnormal molar mass, that is want off factor. Want off factor we are getting 1.95. From this degree of dissociation, dissociation case, degree of dissociation, alpha equal to I minus 1 by N minus 1. Here NaCl, if dissociated, what we are getting, sir? Na plus Cl minus. Here two particles are obtained. So N value means, your N value is 2. Okay, I already we are getting. Substitute here 1.95 minus 1 by 2 minus 1. Therefore 0.95. So this is alpha. Alpha percentage means alpha into 100, 0.95 into 100, that equal to 95% dissociated. How much dissociated, sir, in given NaCl? Total 95% dissociated, only 5% is remaining. Is it clean? Look at here, sir, this is concentration based problem. In order to prepare 100 ml of 0.25 m, means molar, barium chloride solution, the amount of barium chloride is required. Here barium atomic mass, it is heavier element, that's why barium atomic mass they given. Here barium chloride formula, what they given, sir? BaCl2.2H2O. Barium mass, how much here given? 137 plus each chlorine 35.5, means two chlorines, it is 71. One water molecule 18, two water molecules 2 × 18, 36. All together 244. This is the molar mass of barium chloride, molar mass of solute. Come to here, molarity formula. Molarity is equal to molar mass of mass of solute by molar mass of solute into 1000 by volume in milliliters. Volume in milliliter. Okay, now your molar mass of solute is amount of mass they are asking in this problem. In order to prepare 100 ml of 0.025 m barium chloride solution, the amount of BaCl2 is required. So in this problem they are asking how much mass of solute is required. So you separate WB, molarity, into molar mass of solute into volume in milliliters by 1000. Now molarity how much given? 0.25 into molar mass 244. Volume how much they given, sir? Here 100 ml by it become 1000. Here 1000 means 0000 cancel. Okay, sir, here 0.25 means you can write 1/4. 1/4 means 4 × 10, 40. 244 by 40, this is equal to almost 6.1 gram nearly we are getting. So which is the correct option in given all option? Here fourth option is correct. In this problem, 25 ml of 3M HCl were added to 75 ml of 0.05 m HCl. Molarity of the resulting solution. So this is mixed molarity formula, how to use. First one, M1 is 3M, V1 25 ml. Second one, M2, what said, this is 0.05 m, V2 75 ml. These are the values. These two we are put in another container, then mixed molarity is equal to formula M1 V1 plus M2 V2 by V1 plus V2. Substitute that values, a 3 × 25 plus 75 × 0.05 by 25 plus 75, it become 100. Okay, now this is 75 plus how much you are getting? 5 × this value we are getting. (15/4). This value we are going to get how much, sir? 3.75 / 100. It equal to 78.75 / 100. It point 0.787 molar. This is the answer. So in given option, which is the correct option, sir? 0.787. option C is correct. What we are taking? M1 V1 of some solution, M2 V2 of same solute, another solution. Solute is same, volume molarity different. After mixing resultant solution, formula, by using the formula we are getting its mixed molarity 0.787. In this problem, 0.2 moles of HCl and 0.1 mole of CaCl2 was dissolved in water to have 500 ml of solution. Molarity of Cl minus ions is, sir, your 0.2 mole of HCl, 0.1 mole of CaCl2 both dissolved in one solution only. So here 500 ml water we are taken in this 0.2 mole HCl I added. Here another side 0.1 mole CaCl2 added. So some of the H plus ion both cases, some of the Cl minus ion concentration in both cases is equal to molarity of the chloride ion solution. Chloride ion concentration they are asking. First you come to here, HCl dissociate into H plus and Cl minus. Here case 1 molarity, and then 1 mole will give 1 mole. 0.2 they given, here C chloride ion also 0.2. So number of moles of chloride 0.2, number of moles into 1000 by volume 500, 500 ones 2s, therefore 0.4 mole chloride, it is coming from HCl. Okay. Next one, mole per liter you take. Now CaCl2, after dissociating Ca plus 2 to Cl minus, 1 mole if it gives 1, 2, sir we are given 0.1, means this is 0.1, this is 0.2. okay, we are getting like this. Now come to here. In this molarity M2 is equal to chloride ion with respect to CaCl2, how many moles we are getting, sir? 0.2 into 1000 by 500, 2 times it will go 0.4 mole per liter. Here 0.4 mole per liter, therefore chloride ion concentration is equal to 0.4 plus 0.4, it is equal to 0.8 mole per liter or capital M. So among the given options, correct option is B. When 5 grams of BaCl2 is dissolved in water to have 10 power 6 grams of solution, concentration of solution, here they given ppm value, sir. Ppm formula we have to see. Ppm, parts per million, mass of solute by mass of solution into 10 power 6. Mass of solution 5 grams they given, by mass of solution 10 power 6 given into, already in formula here 10 power 6, then 10 power 6 by 10 power 6 cancel, therefore its answer is 5 ppm, option B. In this problem, see, among the following is an incorrect statement. First one, molality of solution is dependent on the temperature. Remember, your molality independent of temperature, there is no volume term. So this is only wrong statement. So incorrect statement is A. So option, what we are getting, sir? A correct option. Look at it. Azeotropic solution of two liquids as a boiling point lower than the either when it, sir, carefully see it, meaning what they given. Here liquid A I am taken, here liquid B taken. Your intermolecular attraction AA will be there. Your intermolecular attraction between BB present. But here boiling point A, boiling point of A, suppose 150 degrees Celsius like that, if you consider your boiling point is equal to suppose your 40 degrees Celsius you consider. These are the two liquids. One is 50 degrees Celsius A, another one 40 degrees Celsius. Azeotropic solution means which can boils at the mixture which can boils at constant temperature, or the which solution having same composition in liquid phase as well as vapor phase, that is we call as azeotropic solution. Carefully see here, there what after mixing at particular A plus B, after mixing at particular composition, this boiling point is lower than A, and this boiling point and also lower than B. And as compared to these two boiling point, mixture boiling point is less. When boiling point is decreases, if the intermolecule after mixing in between A and B molecule attractions, if the very less, escaping nature increases, vapor pressure increases, boiling point decreases. That process we call as positive deviation. Due to positive deviation, this mixture, this with positive deviation, these azeotropic mixtures we can call as minimum boiling azeotropic solution. When boiling point decreases means attractions decrease. Attraction decreases means here boiling point decrease, vaporization increases. That indicate positive deviation from the Raoult's law. It shows a positive deviation. When shows positive deviation, expected value or expected vapor pressure greater than as per Raoult's law, then what will happen? That is positive deviation. This can happen when AB attractions are lower than AA and BB attraction. Then that is we call as minimum boiling azeotropic mixture. It is exhibited due to the positive deviation from the Raoult's law. So based on that, correct option is it shows positive deviation. 27th, it is a complete definition based simple question. You have to go through it. Now come to the 28th. Osmotic pressure of 10% weight by volume aqueous solution of urea P1 is related to 10% weight by volume of aqueous solution of glucose P2. What is this relation? You have to see, sir. Here generally, here mass percentage they given. Pi is equal to, here both are non-electrolyte, non-electrolyte means I value 1. Remaining for I1 means pi equal to CRT. Therefore, osmotic pressure directly proportional to concentration. Case 1, come to here, urea. In urea, concentration I consider as C1. Second one, glucose, its concentration C2. Sir, how much? 10% weight by volume means 10 gram of urea, 10 gram of urea present in 100 ml of solution. So mass of solute, urea mass how much, sir? 10 gram. Molar mass of urea 60 into 1000 by volume how much, sir? 100. Sir, 00 zin cancel, here 00 cancel, 10 by 6. Yes, C1 is 10 by 6, remember. Here C2, 10 by molar mass of glucose 180 into 1000 by volume is 100 ml. 00 cancel, 0 cancel. Here this is 10 by 18. He compares C1 and C2. Denominator value increases. 10 by 6 here, 10 by 18. Carefully see, this is here denominator value what, sir? Here more. So C2 value is less. Based on this, carefully see, C1 greater than C2. C1 greater than C2, you already know pi directly proportional to C. C1 greater than C2 means P1 greater than P2. Instead of pi, they using P, that's all. Nothing is changing. Pi1 greater than Pi2 or P1 greater than P2. In given option, which is correct, sir, here? P1 greater than P2. Okay, option B. Sir, concentration based method problem. 1000 grams of aqueous solution of CaCO3 contain 10 grams of calcium carbonate. Concentration of solution, already you know ppm formula, mass of solute by mass of solution into 10 power 6. Mass of solute only 10 grams they given, by mass of solution 1000 grams into 10 power 6. Carefully see, here it become 10 power 7 by 10 power 3. It equal to 10 to the power of 4 ppm. That is equal to 0004 ppm. 4 zeros means what is the correct option? Fourth one. 10,000 ppm. This is the answer. Cryoscopic constant of liquid is, simply here they are asking definition, sir. Here cryoscopic constant, where it comes, delta TF is equal to KF into M. If M, small m, molality is equal to 1, then delta TF is equal to KF. What is M molality? 1 m means if the solution is 1 molal. 1 molal means 1 molality, meaning what, sir? 1 mole of solute present in 1 kg solvent. If 1 kg solvent, sorry, 1 mole of solute present in 1 kg solvent, then depression in freezing point we consider as cryoscopic constant. Carefully, molality 1, then delta TF become KF. And right here, molality 1 means, here delta TF means depression in freezing point considered as cryoscopic constant. Based on that, correct statement is seen. Here in KF, decreasing in freezing point when 1 gram of solute dissolved in per kg solvent rank. Decreasing in freezing point when 1 mole of solute dissolved per kg solvent. 1 mole solute dissolved in 1 kg. Here M is equal to 1 means mole per kg. 1 mole solute dissolved in 1 kg solvent. This is indicate 1 molality. Then freezing depression in freezing point considered as what, sir? Cryoscopic constant. So based on that, correct option B. Just a definition, sir. If M equal to 1, delta DF is known as, or depression in freezing point is known as cryoscopic constant. Right problem. If the vapor pressure of solutions of two liquids are less than those expected from the ideal solution, they are said to be, remember, sir, here vapor pressure of solution means PT less than P1 plus P2. This is the condition. Again, total pressure is less than as per expected from Raoult's law. According to Raoult's law, sum of the vapor pressure of two liquids must be equal to total vapor pressure in the solution. Now less than they are given, meaning a total, meaning total vapor pressure less than sum of the vapor pressures of two individual components. Here vapor pressure is decreased. When vapor pressure is decreased means after mixing two solutions A, B, after mixing in another container, here one new attractions arise. A, B attractions, if stronger than AA and BB attractions, then what will happen? Here attraction increases, escaping nature of molecule decreases. Therefore, here what will happen? Vapor pressure also decreases. Is it clear? When vapor pressure decreases, remember intermolecular attraction increases, escaping nature and vapor pressure decreases. Boiling point increases, that is different. Come to here. Here what we are, intermolecular attraction increase, escaping nature decrease. So intermolecular attraction increasing indicated negative deviation from the Raoult's law. So simply remember, anywhere if it giving Pt less than P1 plus P2, negative deviation. Pt greater than P1 plus P2, if given like this, this is positive deviation. When attractions decreases, this can happen. Sorry, attractions increases, intermolecular attraction increases, negative deviation. When intermolecular attraction decreases, positive deviation. Okay, so based on that given option, and given all option, correct option is negative deviation from ideal behavior. The solution of benzoic acid dissolved in benzene will show molecular mass close to. Sir, when benzoic acid C6H5COOH, benzoic acid dissolved in benzene, your molecular association will happen, that is C6H5COOH taken twice. Reason, your dimerization will happen. Here dimerization happen. Is it clear? Here 1 mole molecular, before dissolving, 1 mole molecular mass is 122. How, sir? Here 70 actually benzene. Without this CO, carefully see, without CO2, COO, other than this C6H6, 78 plus 44. 78 plus 44, it become 122. How many moles we are taken? 2 moles. 2 mole become here 1 mole. Okay, now. So this mass, how much, sir? Here 2 mole become 1 mole of particle. Is it clear? 1 mole particle mass, here how much nearly we are getting? Double. 244. Very close to the 244. Reason, actually, before going to this problem, you have to see one small point. 1 mole particles, the mass of 1 mole particle we call as molar mass. Here 2 mole, 1 mole particle mass 122, but here taken 2 moles, 2 moles mass is 2 into 122 equal to 244. But after dissolving in benzene, these 2 moles become 1 mole. These 2 moles together become 1 mole, but mass is same. What that is? 244. So your 1 mole particle mass in after dissolving, after dimerization, very close to 244. In this problem, osmotic pressure of the solution having concentration 0.05 m. Here just concentration they given, sir, 0.05 m. osmotic pressure formula CRT. Sir, see, constant value concentration given. R means it is solution constant or universal gas constant. Okay, now if these two are suppose considered as constant, pi directly proportional to temperature. With increasing temperature, osmotic pressure of the solution increases. Based on given option, you check the correct option. Increases osmotic pressure of the solution. Increases with increasing in temperature. Does not change within temperature. Decreases with increasing in temperature. Okay, based on this, what is the correct option? Increases with increasing in temperature. Correct option A. So this problem based on delta TF, depression in freezing point. Pure benzene freezes at 5.45 degrees Celsius at certain place, but a 0.374 mole solution of tetrachloroethane in benzene freezes at 3.55 degrees Celsius. Pure benzene freezes at 5.45 degrees Celsius when dissolved in tetrachloroethane. What will happen? Its freezing point decreases to 3.55. Okay, carefully see here. Delta, sir, first TF naught, freezing point of pure component, that is benzene, 5.44. when it is dissolved, what will happen? If the impurity added or solute added, what will happen? That solute added, freezing point decreases. TF, how much they given? 3. So this is 3.45. This is 3.55. Now delta TF is equal to TF naught minus TF. How much we are getting, sir? 3.55. So here we are getting 1.9 we are getting. Now come to the according to Raoult's law, delta TF is equal to KF into molality. Therefore, KF is equal to delta TF by molality. Delta TF value, how much they given? 1.9. Here, molality they provided here 0.374. If you divided, we are getting 5.08 Kelvin kg mole inverse. This is the value we are getting. Kelvin kg mole inverse, units of cryoscopic constant. What is the 5.08? Based on this, correct option is 1. Read the problem. At certain hill station, pure water boils at 99.725 degrees Celsius. If Kb for water is 0.513 degrees centigrade Kc mole inverse, the boiling point of 0.69 molal solution of urea will be. Sir, hill station generally pressure decreases. When pressure decreases, boiling point of water also decreases. So delta, first TB naught they given 99.725 degrees Celsius. Now KB value from this, this is a keep in pure water boiling point at Hilson. Delta TB is equal to KB into molality. Here see, KB value they provided 0.513 into KB 0.513 and molality of the urea solution 0.69. From this, what you are getting? From this, we got 354 delta TB. Okay, next one. Another formula, delta TB is equal to TB minus TB naught. Now, we can calculate TB. Boiling point of the solution, they are asking TB is equal to, what's that? Delta TB plus TB naught, 0.354 plus TB naught, 99.725. Together, here how much we are getting, sir? In this, here 100.079 degrees Celsius. This is the what, sir? Boiling point of urea solution. What is the correct option? A. This is the delta TF based problem, sir. You see, the freezing point of 0.05 molar solution of non-electrolyte. Non-electrolyte means no association, no dissociation, I value 1. So, direct what formula we can take? Delta TF is equal to KF into M. I value is 1. Multiplying into KF into M, we are getting KF into M. That's all. Sir, here KF, cryoscopic constant, they provide here 1.86 into 0.05. We are getting here 0.093. This is delta TF value, sir. From this, freezing point of solution, they are asking TF. Formula C from this, delta TF is equal to, delta TF is equal to TF naught minus TF. TF naught minus TF. We are calculating TF. Where TF is equal to TF naught delta TF. 0 minus 0.093. Here that is equal to minus 0.093. So option C is correct. The remaining problems we have to continue in next session. Thank you.